And so I'm excited. All right. So welcome everyone to the pop-up action hour. The action hour is a pop-up because I literally decided this morning that I was going to do it. But I just want to kind of offer these a little bit every now and again so that everyone can just have an opportunity to have more connection. So I was just talking recently about like a relaunch. So it'll be 9 years in a couple weeks that I've been a coach. And I was just talking recently about how I have ran my business a very similar way the whole time. And I feel like it's just ready for a revamp and a relaunch. And May is like the month that we're doing it. So I was just spent sitting here kind of getting my calendar together for May and just really excited about the fact that Christina, who is my upline, along with myself, Kate, who's on our team, we are coming up with different ways to get more involved through the computer virtually in our groups with the virtual gym and like little challenges and things, but also as a team that puts on connection and events. So we are going to be hosting more in-person events. And if you're not in the Chicago area, you're more than welcome to always come here and stay with me and come to the events with me or learn how to run them in your business. So something that's really huge and you're going to be hearing about soon, because we're going to be doing some trainings on it, is that live events, are really what build a business like this, because this business is about connection and being the best with each other and for each other. And live events really, and team calls and things like that really kind of ignite you event to event, right? So I remember when I started, my coach Christina said to me that a live event is where you get completely poured into, or a team call is where you get completely poured into. You get excited, you get motivated, you take that motivation, and then you go and you do all the actions. And in that time, you are living off of your belief, but you're also living off of the belief and pouring from the belief that got poured into you. So when people join as coaches, I think that the biggest thing that I always, and customers, you guys, not just coaches, customers, anything, the more that people can immerse themselves in the community, the more they get poured into, the more they can pour into themselves, their family, and anything else they're trying to achieve. So when you get on a team call, you're excited that week you're going, let's say you miss a couple team calls, you're going to notice, because I do this with the national wake up call sometimes, you're going to notice that like, oh, okay, I'm a little bit less motivated. I'm kind of getting distracted here. It's like these events, whether it's virtual or whether it's live, what they do is they give you the fire. They relight your fire to give your fire and expand it. Because this business is nothing more than a transfer of energy and enthusiasm. We are transferring our energy that we're receiving, our enthusiasm for what we're doing, the way that we feel, the like we're just allowing people. And I was just telling Stacy, who is a new coach this week, how awesome she's doing, because she's just naturally enthusiastic about the fact that her daughter did the whole workout with her today. People love hearing that. That's authentic. It's enthusiastic. It's exciting. It's not salesy. It's real. And that's what it's about. So we want to continue that. So we as a team are really amping up to expand on the virtual connection that we can have as well as the in-person. So once again, for those of you that are like, oh, but I'm not in the Chicago area, don't worry. I'm half in Chicago, half in Michigan. So I'll be hosting events in both places. And when I'm in Michigan, I'll be staying at my parents' house, so I can't invite you there. But whenever we have an event here in Chicago, if you guys are more than welcome to stay at my house. I don't have a huge house, but I have beds and I have wine and I have hugs, and we can go to the events together, or I can teach you how to do those events where you are. And I'm more than happy to be there virtually on a Zoom, doing fit clubs, things like that. So stay tuned on that. Today, our whole point is to get on here and do a working action hour. These are going to be pop-up. When I, like Amanda popped on and shared one earlier, I'm popping on now, and it's, no one is ever obligated to get on, but it's an opportunity to connect and work together. So what I'm working off of is the business activity tracker. This is in your online office. You can actually use this virtually. You can use this online. So you can actually check these boxes online. Or for me, I like the PDF version because I like to check the boxes. One page is 1 week, and our week starts on Thursday because Thursday is payday. And this is the beginning of our week for our cycling and forward. So I'm going to just move straight down and we are going to work together through this. So the very first thing is it says So we have the four vital behaviors, the first vital behavior being proof the product works. So in the comments below, let me know, have you been proof that the products work today? Have you done your workout and have you done your shake? Because if yes, then you've already checked off number one, being proof the product works, right? So number two, is about connecting, inviting, and following up with others. Number three is about getting people results. And number four is doing personal development. So pretty much you should be able to do number one, number three, and number four throughout your day here and there in pockets of time. Number two is where I would say you're going to benefit from sitting down and scheduling an appointment with yourself where you sit down and you work through a lot of this. You only need about, to be honest with you, if I get 30 minutes of sit down time to do these activities a day, I can fit the rest in pockets of time. And I feel like I've had plenty of time. But if I try to chase this entire business activity tracker in pockets of time, that's when I get frazzled. Because at the end of the day, we are running a business that we are passionate about. And everyone deserves and needs a little bit of focus to just know, what information am I giving? Who have I been talking to? Keeping your list clean, knowing who you're following up with, checking on your customers, and you need some time set aside to be able to really be present. So I'm just going to give you a tip and say, schedule 30 to 60 minutes every day that you can have for just you in your business. And when you're in your inbox, you're in your inbox, right? When you're not in your inbox, stay out of your inbox. Don't, like, if you're making lunch and your something's in the microwave and it has 2 minutes left and you're like, let me just look. And then you see a message and you want to respond, but now that's done and you got to give it to the kid. There's nothing that's going to serve you from feeling pulled in multiple directions when really we're not supposed to be in the inbox anyway. We're supposed to be doing this. Just trust that if you can put 30 to 60 minutes aside, you're always going to get to the people that need you. You're not going to lose them. They're not going to go anywhere. Everyone understands mom life, working life. And if they don't, then they're not your people and they're not going to understand working with you in general. I've had people who I have stretched myself for to make sure I'm available when they need me. And guess what I've done the whole time that they have, I've coached them. Stretched myself for when they're available and they need me, instead of putting boundaries around, I'm going to be there for you, but these are the times I'm available. And this is when I'm in my inbox. And guess what happens when you do that? People wait and people are patient and people understand. And then all of us work together beautifully, you know? So I just want you to know, try to streamline and treat this business like a business. And it'll pay you like a business. So that means having that time scheduled out the night before of when you're going to work the next day. For me, I will be working, doing an action hour. My goal is at 8 a.m. every, was it 8 or 9? I have it written down as 8, but it might be 9. There's a few of us that are jumping in a Zoom to just do a silent action hour every single day. So when you work your business like a business, you're going to get paid like a business. If you work your business like a hobby, you're going to get paid like a hobby. Your goal and the reason that you're here is not to get paid. You want to earn your cost back and you'd love to earn money, but every single one of us, it matters if we're really helping others too, right? So if you're getting paid like a hobby or paid like a business, whatever it serves you to be here for the long haul, whatever makes you feel good and makes you feel like, yes, this is serving a purpose and I'm so glad I did this, that's what you need to be doing. If you feel like, I wish I had more time for this, carve out that time for yourself. You're worth it. And you're able to have that 30 to 60 minutes a day or every other day, whatever it is. And so just kind of pay attention and set the boundaries. If I could give you guys any tip, any piece of advice, like set the boundaries that you need to have what you want. Because as somebody, when I first started, I had a hard time doing that. And I was just chasing my tail 24/7, trying to fit it in around everyone's schedule, when all I had to do was really say, listen, I need an hour and this is the time I'm going to do it. And I need help. Are you able to help? Or do I need to find someone else to help? But that's okay to do that. So, you know, that's just my story. Anyway, we're going to move through. Two, if you've done your workout and you've done your Shakeology, we are going to jump down to number three for a minute. I want to get you in this space of just cheering others on, feeling the community, understanding the love that we have. So what we're going to do is we're going to contribute to our challenge group. I want you to go into your challenge group and I want you to post your workout if you haven't yet, or post your shake. If you've already done both of those, why don't you just go through, cheer about five or six people on, and just recognize somebody for doing something well. So that's what we're going to do for the next few minutes, because community, like I said, however much we immerse in the community, that's how much we're going to get out of it. And when you are a coach, whatever you do, your customers will do half of what you do. Your coaches will do half of what you do. So I'm not saying you do what's expected of you, and the people are going, you're leading by example, right? So I'm going to move into my challenge group right now, or accountability group, whatever you want to call it. You can also go into your team page if you'd like to do that. And so I'm just going to go ahead and cheer a few people on and make sure my post is in there. So I'll give you guys about 3 minutes to do that. When you're posting in there, try to really share what you're doing as well. So right now I'm sharing that I just did day two of 10 rounds today. It felt so good. I mixed my Recover with my Shakeology, and that's the most delicious way I ever make it, is when I mix the two. This is giving people the opportunity to learn there's something else. What is Recover? They have the opportunity to ask questions, right? So I have the entire neighborhood in my front yard with a babysitter. So if you hear kids, that's why. I also jumped into my team page to do some recognition. Today is Thursday, so the page was just down for Team Beachbody. So I like to always go check and see who have rank advanced, who can I shout out in the team page and everything like that. It was down earlier, so I didn't get to do that, but I would put that on your calendar or on your schedule to do that today. Or as you are growing a team, you can go on and see who you can shout out. If you don't have coaches, that's not going to be there. But that's always an important thing to do. The third thing down here is get people results. That's respond to questions from customers and coaches. That I pretty much always think is like in your inbox responding in your pages. So we just went through the pages. So just go ahead and write down what time you're going to be in your inbox today to answer messages. For me, after the kids go to bed, I'm going to spend 20 minutes answering my inbox. So I'm going to put 9:45 inbox right here. So I know that I'm coming to that. I don't need to worry about that. A lot of times we're pulled to our inbox and we're bouncing back and forth between these activities because it's, we have to know, like, we don't need to come from a place of lack of time, lack of focus, lack of this. We know we have the time. And I just said when I'll be in there. So anyone responding while I'm doing this, I don't even need to worry about, because I know I gave them a time that I will get back to them and I can release that. So we are going to, if you've done your personal development today, go ahead and check that off. Personal development is reading 10 pages of a book that is going to move your mindset, move your soul, move your growth some way, shape, or form. 15 minutes or 10 pages a day is what is recommended. For new coaches, the books that we always recommend, the first one is The Slight Edge. That is a really great book. You can either listen to it, you know, which might be easier when you have small kids, listen to 10 minutes or 15 minutes a day, or you can read it, but it's just going to help you. However you grow your mindset is how much you're going to be able to grow a business, how much you're going to be able to grow yourself. And that's what we're here for, is self-growth. It also helps you on your fitness journey and just, you know, keeping strong and staying in that abundance mindset, opposed to where we can sometimes slip. The main reason that people quit with nutrition and fitness and business is because it gets a little bit hard, and consistency is hard, and change is hard, and habit changing is hard. And what happens is our mindset isn't there to support the change. So that's why this piece is so important. I have not read 10 pages yet. I've read 3. So I have 7 to do later. So I'm not checking that off. And I'm just going to write before bed, so I know I'm getting to that. All right. So we are bouncing back up to our second vital behavior, which is connect, invite, and follow up. These are your business building, income building activities. The first one is going to be initiating connections and adding followers. So we are going to spend 10 minutes doing this. If you've already made a social media post today, you can go ahead and check that off. I did that. We'll actually just check this off too in the update Instagram, Facebook story throughout the day. So I'm going to check that off. I have just random daily life stories, because people like to see who you are, because then they know, like, and trust you. They know that you have kids and you're just like them. They see that you like this type of music and you're just like them. Workout clips. I always put my workout in there, and I did already. Product use, but no brand name shown, because of curiosity marketing. One of the biggest questions I get asked on my social media is, what is the drink you're drinking in your video every morning? What is that yellow drink? What is that pink drink? And I can then take it to a conversation, share it with them, share a video, and help get that in their hands if that's what they want. So often we think that what we need to do is deliver a total solution pack to them, but we don't. We need to deliver the information they want, offer them an upgrade, and then be okay with whatever they want to do. Because no matter what, we're just trying to fulfill what they need. And once they're in the group, or once they're using one thing, they're typically excited to use something else. And even if they're not, that's still a new connection. That's still someone who can refer other people to you. So always be, I feel like a lot of people will get really down if they don't get total solution packs and they only get the fitness or they only get the shakes. I always go for total solution. I always want to get people that total solution. But if all they want is Energizer, all they want is bars, or all they want is collagen after the whole consultation, then I'm excited that that's what they want, because they're going to refer people. They're going to love it. I'm going to give them a great experience no matter what. And we can move forward. So product use with no name, I can check that off. A healthy meal or meal prep, I have not done that yet. Invitation, promote group, poll, or call to action, I have done that. And a recognition or shout out, I have not done that. So right now, let's just take a couple minutes. Let's take about 4 minutes to go into our stories. If you haven't shown your workout in your stories, if you haven't shown, maybe talked about the group that's coming up or shouted someone out, then make sure to go do that. Stacy, I am actually going to show you, well, both of you, I don't know if you use them or not, Stacy with a Y, but if you go into the 2022 coach life, and you scroll up. Actually, I'm just going to send it to you. I can, Stacy with a Y, do you use our mompreneur slides or do you have your own for the May, for like the challenge groups in your stories?
I have, not mompreneur, something else.
Okay. So you have your own thing that you do with that.
Yep.
Okay. So Stacy with an IE, I am going to send you right now in your Facebook Messenger some stories. You are going to save them in order, and then you can literally put them in your stories, and it's going to promote the May challenge group coming up. And then you could even just put in writing on there, so excited to be a part of my full, like my first full month in this community, in this accountability group. I'm looking for people to be my workout buddy and my partner in here. If you're interested, drop your name here and you can put like a little question thing on there. So what you'll do is I'll send you these and then let me see here. I want to send you those. Boop, 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 boop. Oh, that's not it. Okay. Send 8. So they should be in order. And then you'll just save them. And then they're actually these. If you've looked at my stories today, you've seen them in my stories. And so you can just put those in. And when you get to the last one and you put this in your story, it says ready to make your mark. You can swipe up when you're in your stories. Have you done a story before? No. Okay. So you can, and you're doing Facebook primarily, right? Not Instagram. Okay. So you'll go to stories and then you go to create story and you can select all of those. So you'll select one at a time. So let me go. So you'll select this and then you'll hit go, select this and you'll go through them all. When you get to this last one here, so it comes up like this, you can swipe up and this little screen comes like that. You can't really tell, but this comes up. And you can click poll or you can click question. I usually do question and it'll say ask a question and you can put drop your name if you're interested. You type that in, hit done, move it to where you want it. And then you just hit share to story. So people can actually come to this. And when they see this on your story, they can put their name in there. And then how you would notice if people are doing that is right next to this is my story. When I go to my story, I can swipe up and see all the people who have viewed my story, but I can also scroll over to any one. And I'll show you an example because someone filled out this one. So if someone drops their name, when you swipe up, it'll look like this and you can actually click on it and send them a message right there. So that's something you can play around with also. Okay. So, in your stories, if you haven't given a shout out or any something, go ahead and do that right now. I'll give you one more minute since I was talking, Stacy, you can just save those and do that later or whatever you want to do. And then, okay. All right. So let's go ahead and go to the next part then. You can continue doing what you want. We're going to go into our four building. These are kind of like our income producing activities. The first one is initiating connections and adding followers. So what I do is on Instagram, to initiate connections and add followers, I will go typically to a page that I would follow. So I'm going to search and go to, we'll just say Marissa Hart. She's like this sexy dancing girl. I've never done her stuff, but I'm intrigued because I want to learn to dance like that. As of recently, my friend Liz just showed me and I was like, ooh, that looks like fun. So if I go to her page, and I like this, let's say, then I know that what the people that follow her, we're going to have similar interests, probably, at least in that. So I will go ahead and follow about 25 people to get them. What they're going to do is come look at my page and see if they want to follow me back, right? So this is how I add followers on Instagram. On Facebook, what you can do is go to people that you suggestions, friends that they suggest, and you can just add some friends. In moms groups, if you're in any certain types of groups on Facebook, you can make some sort of post, not about this, just in general. And when people are having dialogue, you can add a friend request. You don't ever need to say, this is why I'm sending the friend request. This is all about just connecting and just adding followers to your account. So right now, go ahead and add, I would say, let's go ahead and add for 8 more minutes, go ahead and add some people, add some friends from either suggestions or follow some new people to kind of gain some new followers. And then after you've added about, I would say 10 on Facebook or about 25 on Instagram, then you can go ahead and initiate connections. And what I like to do is look at my friends' stories for this, and I'm just initiating just general connections and look on people's stories and just send a heart or send a comment about their stories. You can also do this on people's pages. If you just go through your newsfeed and you see like a post and you're like, oh my gosh, where are you? I noticed you're somewhere tropical. I didn't even know you were on vacation. Where are you? This is just getting people more connections, new connections, and then connecting with some of them that are already there. So we're going to go ahead and spend 8 minutes doing that. Now, if you're somebody who has a lot of comments on your stuff, and you haven't been able to respond, this would also be a way of connecting with people. So I'm going to take this time to add some people to my network, but then also just connect by responding to the people that are already commenting on my stuff that I haven't responded yet. Yes.
Mm-hmm. No, what? I need my iPad.
Oh. There you go.
How much the sand is on?
I don't know.
It's on 93.
93%. I love you.
I am a mother's daughter. I watched her with my father. I saw it all, the good and bad. Should have known better than that. You found me at the right time. I loved you from that first night. Bet everything on what we had. Should have known better than that. I gave you my heart, you let it go to waste. You made me do the leaving, then you made me take the blame. Doesn't make you feel good to make me feel bad. Yeah, you should have known better. Should have known better than a brother. What you couldn't fix. Boy, what a shame. What you gonna miss? Why'd you go and do what you can't take back?
All right, we're going to spend one more minute on this.
I've seen pickup lines and dive bar strangers slow dance. I've seen happy hour two for ones turn to one night stands. I've seen neon rebounds and late night drunk dives. I've seen that Cinderella fairy tale go up in cigarette smoke. I've seen two hearts bid it all and still end up broke. Real thing won't be easy. Yeah, it might take a while.
All right, so let's go ahead and move into the next thing then, which is responding to new likes, comments, and or views. So you can go into your stories, connect there, thank people for watching, connect to your polls, respond to people there, respond on comments and connect via comment opposed to taking it to a message. So that's what I would think about how it would be different is like if I'm connecting in the connection phase, I'm taking it more to a message where if I'm just connecting or I'm sorry, what am I responding to those, then pretty much I'm just kind of keeping it more being social on social media. So we are going to go ahead and take about 5 minutes to do that on our newest posts, newest reels, newest story polls and such. All right, so we are going to move on to the next piece now, which is inviting five people to learn about to join about the challenge group or learn about coaching. What I like to do is before my action hours, I always go over the week and what's coming up and what I need to be inviting to. So right now for me, we have a fit club on Friday. So I'm going to be inviting people that are local to this live fit club. I'm also going to be inviting people to join for May because it is a May. The May is group is about to kick off. And also I'm really focusing on coaching. So I actually just put a post out right before this action hour. And this is another tip is when I know I'm going to do an action hour, I usually put a post up a couple hours before that is like, these are the opportunities I have to offer when, and talk about something that has to do with something I'm going to be inviting to so that I have some comments that I can already talk to people about for one or for two, when I'm inviting people off of my stories or off of people that are liking or commenting or just following or whatever, that I can say, hey, I just made this post earlier. I'm really excited about May and I am kicking off this group. I'm looking for people that are just ready like I am to completely feel different. And May is the month. I know it is for me. I don't know if it is for you, but have you seen that post? Does it resonate with you? Is this something we could talk about more? It takes the invite to a completely different place. It's not cold because you're not cold inviting someone to look at a product. You're not cold inviting someone to look at a thing to purchase. You're asking them if they saw what you said and what you want. And if they're in that space too, where then that conversation can move forward. So I like to refer to a post or a story when I'm inviting people. So go ahead and we are going to invite, I will say, what time is it right now? It is 5:47. So we are going to take the next 10 minutes to invite. And I would say, try to get five people. For me, I'm always kind of going more for coaching than anything. Remember, what you talk about is what people are going to be attracted to. So if you've been talking about challenge groups more, then obviously inviting to that is going to be a little bit more natural. And yeah, so go ahead and we are going to go for a goal of inviting five.
Just tell me to breathe easy for a while. Breathing gets harder, even I know that. It's too soon to see if I'm happy in your hands.
Now, as you're inviting, write down who you're inviting to. I write it on a piece of paper, and then I have a spreadsheet on Google Drive. It's just easier for me to put it on the paper first. I move quicker, and then I can transfer it to the drive so that I know who I'm talking to. When you don't track, Christina always says, you don't track, you don't have a list, you don't have a business. And it's true because you don't remember to follow up, and the fortune is in the follow-up.
But they all say things you wanna hear. too much and I talk too fast. Might be born in the same year, but born we at the same age. I'd be reading the same book, but we ain't on the same page. Nah, it ain't your fault, boy. Not even gonna make it say it. I'll make a call, boy. I can't help it.
One more minute and we will be moving on. All right. So the last few minutes we are just going to spend doing kind of whatever you need to do. If there's a few people you need to follow up with and get information to, do that. If there's a few more invites you need to get out, do that. If you need to just schedule your day for the next day, do that. I have a few more invites, responses I'm doing for something, and I'm going to write those down. And then I already know that tonight after bedtime, I'm reading and I'm getting into my inbox. So I don't need to worry about anything else. Our entire list will be checked off today and we will be successful. So 3 minutes, spend it just wrapping up however you feel like you need to. All right. I got 2 invites out for coaching, 6 invites out for the boot camp, and 3 invites out for gut protocol. I'm going to go ahead and stop the recording, wrap this up for the night. I will be working for a few more minutes. Stacy, you're welcome to stay on or jump off, but thank you for joining live. And thank you for everyone watching the recording. I'll be trying to do these pop-up working hours just to kind of get together. But remember, every morning we are doing it. I will post it in the team page and chat what time in the action hour link because I forgot. But anyway, okay. Thank you guys so much for joining and have a great day.